Welcome to our class, Interior, Exterior, and Boundary of a Set. So we define interior point of a set as follows. Let S be a topological space and disk happens. A point S in A is called an interior point of A. If there is an open set G, such that this happens. So this is equivalent to the definition of an open set. In fact, we can define an open set as a set that contains all its interior points. Now, what we have here is interior of a set. The set of all interior points, if you have interior points of A, the set of all of them, that is the collection of all of them, or the combination of all of them, is called an interior of A. You see, it's different from interior point. This one, the interior of A, is denoted by A raised to power 0, or we just simply write interior of or int A. So this is how we denote the interior point. Now let's take the following theorem. We have the theorem here. Let S be a topological space and let this happen. Number one, the interior of A is the union of all open sets contained in A, or let's say all open subsets of A. Another one, interior of A is open. Another one, A interior of A is the largest open subset of A. That is, if G is open subset of A, then G is a subset of interior, which is this. And finally, A is open if and only if A is equal to its interior, just like what we defined the other time. Now, let us start from the first one. Proof. Since it's a union of all the open sets in A, so we need to find an open collection of open sets by saying, let GI be collection of all open subsets of A. What we want to show is that we want to show that this interior is union of this GI. Now, better way to show that is to first show that this is a subset of union of GI. Also, we show that union of GI is a subset of this. Now, let's prove the first one. So we start by saying, we start by picking an element in this. Now, if you want to show a subset, you only need to pick an element here. If the element also belongs to this, then you have proved that this is a subset of this. Now, let S belong to this interior. Then, by definition of interior point, you know, definition of interior point, we see that there exists an open set G. So, by definition of interior point, there exists some open sets, because we have open sets here, GI, such that S belongs to the GI, is a subset of A. Now, we can write this thing as this, S belongs to GI, which simply means that X belongs to union of GI. And we have seen that S belongs to A naught. From that, we got this. So this simply means that A raised to power naught is a subset of union GI. So we have proved the first part. For the second part, we know that since GI is contained in A by the theorem, so since GI is contained in A, so definitely the union, okay, the union will contain in them interior of A, which is same thing as A naught. So we have shown that this is 1, this is 2. So from 1 and 2, so we can conclude that A naught is equal to union this GI. Remember, GI is an open subset. Now, for the second one, we have to show that A naught is open. Remember, A naught is equal to this. Since we can say that since G, each GI is open. And union of open set is open. You can see here, A raised to the power 0 is union of all open set. And we have proved before that union of open set is open. So therefore, A naught is open. So that completes the proof of the second one. And the third one, we want to show that this is subset of this and is a subset of this. For the third one, we want to show that A naught is the largest open subset of A. Now let's consider all the open subset of A. So we start by saying the third one. Let G be an open subset of A. Don't forget that GI is a collection. GI is a collection of all the open subsets. Definitely, GI will be a collection of these. So from that place, G, it will be a subset of this. What we are saying there is that we have assumed before here that let GI be the collection of all open subset of A. So we now pick a set inside it which is also open. Definitely that set will be inside this collection. So definitely it will be inside the union of all of them. And this will simply imply that, remember, this thing means A naught. We have proved this in the first one. This thing simply means A naught. But we know that A naught must be contained in A. So this simply means G is a subset of A naught. And A naught is a subset of A. So we have proved this. So we have proved the third one. The fourth one, we have to show that A is open if and only if A is this. Now, since A is open, definitely we know that A naught must be a subset of this. So let's keep that. But we know that A naught is an open subset of itself. Don't forget that this is open. Also, A is an open subset of itself. Definitely this one is also a subset of itself, and this is open. So this is two. If you compare the two, this thing simply means A is equal to A naught. And that completes the proof. Now, this one here will enable us to find the interior point and interior of a set, because it's the largest open subset of A. Now let's take an example. So we have our example here. Let S be this and let tau be this. Be a topology on S. If A is this, find interior of A. So solution. Before we find the interior of A, we need to find all the subsets of A. Let's find all the subsets of A. That is, we know how to find the subset of a set. So we find it as follows. So these are the subsets of A, that is the power set of A. We know how to find the power set of a set. Now, out of all of these, some are open. If you look at this, S is open. This is open. A is open. So from this place, the open subsets of A are, what are the open subsets of A? This is part of it. Okay, it's not there. CD, there's CD there. CD. All these things are open. ACD. But I don't think there's ACD here. So this is the only open. So I'll put is then, because I have only one there. So the only open subset of A, let me use ordinary this. The only open subset of A is this. Therefore, it's also the largest. Our interior is C, comma D. And the interior points are C and D. So those are the interior points. Now let's take the following theorem. Theorem 2. If A is a subset of B, then A naught is a subset of B naught. Now the proof of the theorem. So let's pick an element in A naught. Then by definition, there exists an open set G such that S belongs to G is a subset of A. And whenever we have this, in this place, A is a subset of B, which means I can write it as this. G is a subset of A, it's a subset of B. By transitive law, I can write it as this is a subset of B. I can remove this and put this there. And when this thing happens, this thing means S belongs to B naught. And that shows that we have shown that when S belongs to A naught, then S belongs to B naught. This simply means that A naught is a subset of B naught. And that completes the proof. Let's consider another theorem. For any sets A and B in topological spaces, interior of A union interior of B is a subset of this. Now, let's prove the first one. We know that for any sets A and B, A will be a subset of A union B. And then B will also be a subset of A union B. And by the theorem we just proved, by our theorem 2, we are going to have that the interior will be a subset of this interior. And then B naught will be a subset of A union B naught. So that is the theorem we just proved now about interior point. Is the theorem here, if A is a subset of B, then A naught is a subset of B naught. So the same thing happens to this. If you take the union of both sides, this union this, A naught union B naught will be a subset of A union B naught. And that proves this. For the second one, we want to prove that this is equal to this. Now, we are going to prove it in two ways. We prove that this is a subset of this, and we also need to prove that this is a subset of A naught intersection B naught. Now, this is B naught. Also, for any sets A and B, A intersection B will be less than this. Sorry, will be a subset of this. And A intersection B will also be a subset of B. Unlike this one, this is union. This one will be a smallest one. So in that case, this one will be smaller than this. So it will be contained in A. By our theorem 2, the same thing, we have that this one is a subset of this. And this one too. It's a subset of this. And if you take the intersection of both sides, you are going to have that this one is a subset of this. So we have proved this part. So we are now left to prove this part. So we write conversely. So we need to show that A naught this is a subset of A naught B naught. Now let's take an element in this place. Let X belong to A naught intersection B naught. By normal set theory, we normally write it as S belongs to this, and then S belongs to this. So then, by definition, there exists an open set G such that, you know, definition of interior point, because this thing means S is an interior of A and S is also an interior of B. So that is what we are trying to say there. There exists an open set G such that S belongs to G, is a subset of A, and S belongs to G, is a subset of, let's say, B. Which we can write as this. S belongs to this. It's a subset of A intersection B. If we take the intersection, it will still be a subset. Since this is a subset of this and it's a subset of this, it will still be a subset of their intersection. Now, if when this thing happens, this thing simply means S belongs to A intersection B naught. And that simply means that A naught intersection B naught is a subset of A intersection B all naught. So, and from this, let's say this is 2. Let's say this is 1. From 1 and 2, you can conclude that A naught B naught is equal to A intersection B all naught. And that completes the proof. Another important one is the exterior point. We define exterior point as follows. We say that let S be a topological space and this happens. A point S in this is called an exterior point of A. If there is an open set G containing S such that G intersection A is empty, it's just the opposite of the interior point. So when this thing happens, when G intersection is empty, then we say that that point X is an exterior point of A. So the set of all the exterior points of A is called the exterior of A, to which A is denoted as this, exterior of A. And we also define exterior of A as exterior of A is interior of A complement. So this is all about exterior point and exterior of A. Another interesting one is boundary of A, boundary point of A. We say that a point S in this is called a boundary point of A, or we call it a frontier point of A, if it is neither interior nor the exterior. If it is neither interior nor the exterior, we say that it's a boundary. So the set of all boundary points of A is called boundary of A, which is written as this, the set of all of them. So from the definitions, we can conclude that a topological space or the whole space S can be written as an interior of A plus, union exterior of A union boundary of A. All of them together will become a topological space S or a whole space S. Let's take a theorem. Let S be a non-empty subset of a topological space S. Then A bar is equal to A naught, that is interior of A union boundary of A. That is what the theorem says. Now, before we prove the theorem, let's do some analysis. Remember that we have said S is interior of A union exterior of A union boundary of A. Now this thing simply means that the exterior of A will be equal to interior of A union boundary of A complement. Now the complement of the whole thing, because all of them are inside there, so exterior will be interior union boundary complement. So it's the one that will give us this. So it is not easier for us here. So we cannot say that it suffices to show that A bar complement is equal to exterior of A. Why? Because we want to show that A bar is this. And this thing simply means exterior. This thing, if you find a complement of this thing, will give us exterior. So definitely, if you're going to find the complement of this, we are going to have exterior. Now, let S belong to A bar complement. We want to show that it will be equal to it will be inside them, exterior. So if this happens, this thing simply means that S does not belong to Eva. And when this thing happens, you know, by definition of Eva, we know that Eva is same thing as A union A this. We have shown it in our previous class. And this thing simply means that S does not belong to A. Also, S does not belong to Eva. If S does not belong to this, this thing simply means that S is not a limit point of A. And if S is not a limit point of A, then there exists an open set G such that G intersection A is empty. Remember, is equal to empty. Remember, under limit point, we see that a limit point, if it's a limit point, you know, G intersection A will never be empty. And since it's not a limit point, then G intersection A will be empty. So this is just the definition of our exterior point that we give. You can see, we say that if it's an exterior point, then G intersection A will be empty. So this thing simply implies that S belongs to an exterior of A. So in that case, we have now shown that A bar complement is a subset of exterior of A. Now that is a sub. So we have only shown it's a subset here. We need to now show that exterior point is also a subset. Exterior of A is also a subset of this. So we say that let S belongs to this, then there is this, by definition, since S is an exterior point, by definition of exterior point, there exists an open set G which containing S such that G intersection A is empty. That is our definition. And whenever this thing occurs, this thing will simply mean that S does not belong to. And you see that it's still the same definition of derived set. So our limit point, S does not belong to it. And if S does not belong to this, S will not belong to this as well. A. Because remember, A is contained in ordinary A. So this simply means S does not belong to A union this. And this simply means S does not belong to A bar. And if S does not belong to A bar, this will simply imply that S belongs to A bar complement. So which simply means that exterior of A is also a subset of A bar complement. So which simply means that A bar complement is equal to exterior of A. But we know that exterior of A is just the same thing as interior of A union boundary of A complement. So if we cancel out the complement, we will now see that A bar is equal to this union B of A. So, and that completes the proof. So have a nice day. We'll continue in our next class.